outside over there, where the war was raging. Run, little child, far from home. The Lord will take you with him. As mushrooms high as mountains came from Neptune's submarine, a little girl named Ida lived in a shack up by the sea. Her daddy was away at war, her mother had lost her mind. So Ida in the arbor softly sang her lullaby to hush her baby sister and to calm her mother's shake. Then by the waves crashing for her father she would wait. One evening Ida sang her song, soft as May breeze blows, when a blinding flash of light came and her eyes began to close. Devils in their hooded cloaks through the window climbed. They took her sister in the dark and ran off in the night. When Ida went to check the crib, when finally she arose, she found a figure made of ice melting by the stove. Outside over there, where the war was raging, run, little child, far from home. The Lord will take you with him. Ida put on her mother's coat and walked out to the cliffs. The sky was scarred with napalm, the hills were drowned with mist. She buried a rose in the ground, then started up the road to find her sister night and safely bring her home. There were soldiers in the twilight, thieves drinking by the cave. She just listened out for her daddy's voice to come drifting across the waves. At the edge of Neptune's kingdom was a forest, and it was said that any man who went in there was never seen again. But Ida clutched her mother's coat and pressed on through the trees. For in the ground she saw the tracks of wretched devil's feet. The path ahead grew fainter as the branches tied in knots. And Ida felt like every step she took was being watched. Outside over there, where the war was raging, run, little child, far from home. The Lord will take you with him. After many miles of walking, the child began to tire. When she came across a cabin, windows flickered with a fire. She knocked upon a wooden door, an old man showed his face, with kind eyes like her father's and a beard long and gray. She saw her sister sleeping near two angels wearing hoods. She had some supper and she slept a dream about the woods. After 3 days passed, the mist had cleared, the sky was clear and bright. She took her sister in her arms and bid the man goodbye. She ran back through the forest, saw no soldiers or no thieves, till she found herself back up at the shack by the sea. But when she wrapped her arms around her mother, she shed tears. For the woman stood before her was blind and aged by 30 years. She said, "Oh, my darling Ida, my wait is at an end. As this rose bush grew, I prayed each day that we would meet again." So they sat out in the garden, and the sun shone all around, till early the next morning, when their bodies were